I got the other one started up.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, let's change this. Since you're now back in a Carl's.
Yes.
Neum. Neum.
Hope Henderson had a go have a nice heart to heart with his baby.
We can side role play that sometime, Ink, if you really want to.
Okay. Okay. Yay. Yeah, it's okay. They just dad and son around in bed.
Okay.
Pretty much just right. Henderson just wants to be around his son.
Yeah. He's like, oh my god, you're my last one.
Oh no.
Still has tiny baby hope. It's called denial.
Oh no. Henderson.
Baby Henderson, no. Please. You need to stop, sir.
Please, you're making us all very sad.
Oh, no. Can't stop. Can't let the sad thoughts catch me.
I gotta keep running.
If I go really fast, it'll never catch me. Okay.
Okay. So, you said we have a week between stuff?
Yeah. At least a week.
At least. Okay. So, new glasses have not come in yet? Or haven't picked up them yet? Or...
You don't have them yet, no.
Okay, so I have cracked lenses.
Yep, you are looking real classy there.
I am the most classy. Okay. Well. He'll try this anyways, because, hey, cracked lenses or no, he's got stuff to do.
Gotta get the business done.
The duty.
Gotta get that gossip.
Yeah. Duty.
So he is going to initiate plan, talk to Lauren.
Okay.
And I don't know if Theo wants to somehow clue in on Lemon starting to pick up bird stuffs. Like, it looks like he's getting ready to go bird watching.
It's just a Lemon thing that Lemon does. I can roll a Percepti.
You may roll a Percepti. Tell me what you get.
Babe. Oh, Jesus Christ.
You key I got... on that lemon.
Yum.
Zoom in. I got 5 successes.
You hear an eagle in the distance, and I guess it really is time to go bird watching.
You hear a Sara cry.
Oh no.
Time to go bird watching.
She knows that you're cheating on her with other birds.
So Lemons is, he's grabbing a blanket and he's grabbing like a little, making himself a little picnic with what limited knowledge he has on just assembling some foodie foods.
He says, he makes like a really gross looking sandwich.
It's a really plain, like, peanut butter and jelly or something like that.
You just put, like, cheese between 2 pieces of bread. She's not even trying.
Butters it, put some cheese on it, boom, that's it, right?
Ew. Theo will lean over the counter in the kitchen, be like, do you want some help with that?
He looks over, kind of looks at his meager, little, sad sandwich. You know, I'll actually roll a craft for this.
roll to make the best sandwich.
I will roll my most beautiful sandwich. It's a -3 to do this. It's a luck die.
Do it.
I have.
You critically failed at the sandwich.
What was it?
I'm like making a mess.
Okay.
Critically failed.
I'm combining the two most awful things together.
It's a critical failure. It's worse than that.
Okay.
So you're like, well, I'm gonna make a sandwich, so I need bread, right? Okay, so
moldy bread.
I'm gonna grab this bread, open it up, doesn't even notice it's moldy. just put that down on a plate, doesn't even notice the plate's dirty.
Oh, no.
And gotta put some mayo on there, doesn't notice it's Miracle Whip. some cheese.
Doesn't notice it's
No, no, the cheese is fine.
Oh, no, no, no. It's he puts in the shredded cheese instead of, like, the...
sliced cheese.
Yes, the sliced sandwich cheese.
Gotta put that on there. And basically... second.
It's a mustard.
Oh, God. A mustard.
Mustard mayo cheese sandwich on moldy bread.
Puts in some of Nat's leftovers, which are which are just tainted with hot sauce.
And you know, you make it. It's it's definitely a sandwich. You remember that one SpongeBob episode?
Oh God, the Sunday.
Oh my God. He just kind of looks at it.
Or maybe something, I think this is... I feel like this one's more accurate with the stuff you had around.
Oh, Jesus.
I totally zoned out for a second and now I am completely lost.
Lemon's critically failed at making a sandwich and he basically made the grossest sandwich.
I have successfully made the worst possible thing to ever make.
It's like he got two pieces of moldy bread, put them on a dirty plate, put Miracle Whip on them, put shredded cheese. Miracle Whip. Some mustard.
Oh, I was thinking Cool Whip. I was like,
Cool Whip. Yeah, Cool Whip.
It's Cool Whip instead of Miracle Whip.
Some of Nat's leftovers.
Is that uncooked macaroni?
Yes. SpongeBob macaroni. Honestly, that's probably more of what it is than the
probably.
Other. But like, the bread's gross, and you put the Miracle Whip and the shredded cheese, and it's just gross. Yeah.
Is Theo like watching in amazement?
He's watching in horror. This is an affront.
And like Lemons is like humming, like it's like a normal thing. Until Theo stops him. He's like, no, honey, no.
He's like, oh, okay, no.
He's just. Lemons is like, what?
Nope. He just like puts his hands on Lemon's back and gently shoves him away from the sandwich prep station. Nope.
He moves away. He's like, I was making a masterpiece.
You were making a disaster.
Can I roll to see if I realize it is the worst awful sandwich ever?
Just eat it, Lemons. Just eat it. You eat trash, Lemons. Just eat it.
You can try an empathy, Theo.
Okay.
Wasn't hey, you don't know why he's upset.
You think he's like making like playing a game and that it's really just fine and he's just like, oh no, that's the worst sandwich. So you eat.
Like, if you wanted to make a sandwich for me, you could have just said you wanted to make a sandwich for me.
He's just mumbling that as he
It's like he sounds like he doesn't even realize why you're so upset. How is this an affront? Just perfectly good sandwich.
Did you not even look at what you were putting on this?
I see some cheese and
you put shredded taco cheese on a sandwich.
It's cheese, right? You put cheese.
Put it on moldy bread.
I am so tempted to have him take a bite to prove that it's edible.
Do it. It's be like, the worst.
I made a sandwich, and it's totally an edible sandwich. And he goes, You know,
is he going for it?
Yes.
Lemons roll a toxin resist.
I think this roleplay might have to be postponed if he gets himself sick.
If he fails and just looks down at the bite he's taken. I've made a mistake.
Is stamina toxin? Or, yeah. Is it... Oh, it's not natural immunity, it's just toxin, right? Or no, because sickness and disease, that's natural and
yeah, yeah.
Oh, do that one then, I don't care.
Okay. I made it.
You're fine. What's the deal?
What's wrong? Fine.
He was just staring at you horrified.
Oh, I made it! He's just kind of chewing, slowly stops, realizes that,
that this isn't normal.
Oh, right, this
is
how they-
The poison or disease is stamina plus resolve.
What?
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 Oh, what? It's stamina resolve, it's not just stamina.
What would you get?
That's what it says.
I added another success, so I have 3 success.
You're fine.
Yeah. Well, he slowly stops chewing. I mean, he probably, you know what? He'll just like kind of like shuffle over the trash and just kind of dump the sandwich in, and just kind of lean over and spit out what he was chewing. Although he probably did swallow his first bite, to be fair.
Because it's lemons.
He's like a snake. He just unhinges his jaw and swallows without chewing.
Yeah, spits it out and, you know, just kind of... Okay. Feel free to make me something better. I'm not a very good chef.
Do you not have taste buds either?
just kind of... Staring back through the broken lenses.
I think he was going to start clearing up the horrible sandwich remains that are left on the counter, and he will make you some actual food.
I can tell what's good.
You just ate a moldy sandwich!
What, that was moldy?
With Cool Whip on it!
I'll...
This is a mess. This is wonderful. This is... Garbage always happens. Good job.
See? Garbage. Garbage people eating garbage things.
It's true.
Lemons has no way to console the fact that he is a trash baby eating trash.
You just got caught eating trash.
Pretty much. So he gets a cup, gets some water, rinses his mouth out.
pretending like, ugh,
nasty.
Like he has regrets.
drinks... Go ahead.
He's actually just disappointed he had to throw away food.
Lemons pretend to have regret.
Oh no.
Do you have to roll?
You have to roll to pretend to have regret.
I have to roll to pretend. That's subterfuge because I'm pretending, right?
Yep. You are acting.
I am the acting. Can I striking looks it?
Sure.
You look dashing while you're swigging water.
I should say no, but...
Fine, you can say no because...
No, it's okay. Oh. You look gorgeous always.
It's lemons.
Oh, no,
can't
wait.
Stop.
It's... Oh, shit. It's acting, so that would be expression, not subterfuge.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, you're lying, technically, as well. I'd take either.
I will take that subterfuge, thank you.
Take all the dots you can get.
Take every dot. Plus lying or no? Yeah.
No. Sure.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
No.
Leo.
Somebody.
Oh my God! All those dice and I got one.
You're just like, oh, ew. Yeah.
And then he pops a piece of gum.
Just to cement it. Gonna clean your mouth out.
Clean his trashy mouth out.
Nobody can ever save you from the trash, Lemons.
Oh, did you find the cage guy's place?
What?
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. I should have muted.
Oh, okay.
So he's gonna hover and watch Theo make something way more delicious. If you roll it. Okay.
There you go. Three successes.
Start smelling it. It smells good.
Yeah. Well, if it's picnic food, then it needs to be, like, decently able to carry, so...
Theo's, like, trying to explain the steps of making a good sandwich.
He's just, like, talking to himself as he makes the...
It's like, don't put the wet stuff against the bread or it'll make it soggy.
Yeah, you gotta buffer, you know, some lettuce in there.
well,
keep everything from going to mush.
While he's talking, Lemons had snuck up on him. Not snuck up, just walked up and is like peering over his shoulder.
Hovering.
Yep. Mm hmm.
Mm hmm.
Mm hmm.
And you know, you have to actually make sure the ingredients you're using are good and not expired.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't just have a cheese sandwich, like...
Why not? I mean, cheese is edible.
Cheese is edible, but, like, that's weird.
So is bread. Cheese and bread are both edible.
Well yeah, they're food. Thank you for this enlightening conversation, guy.
Just watches him.
Then eventually, ta-da! Oh. Magnificent. Magnificent sandwich for you.
Yay.
Or it's a decent sandwich. It got a 3.
He smiles. It's a good picnic. Thank you. I was going to go on a picnic, but more of just going bird watching.
Yeah.
Mainly to catch me a wild lorn, if you get my drift. You want to come on?
What were you going to talk with her about?
Mainly about the gargoyles.
Oh yeah, they like kids, right?
Yeah, but also to, because I figure that she isn't aware of what's going on yet with Timothy.
Oh,
I don't think she's been told yet.
Theo looks guilty. He just says, no, she doesn't know.
Hmm. See, we have a reason to do this then. And if it doesn't pop up, then we're just talking to her about gargoyles anyways. But here, I'll let you in on what I'm thinking, okay? Here is a brief insight into the mind of the lemon.
Did he say that out loud?
Yes. As he, like, moves forward and, like, encircles an arm around Theo and, like, gets close in a conspiratorial huddle.
The giggling is real.
Okay, so...
An insight into the mind of a lemon.
So, I was thinking, and then you would be a part of this since you have caught me in my endeavors of trying to execute the first part of my plan. I was going to... sidetrack. So kind of in character, kind of out of character. I'm trying to remember where he was talking. He was going to let her in on the...
Let the right one in.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Shit, what was I talking about?
Lemon's plan.
Yeah, I know, but... Okay, he told her that his plan was to talk to her at the park. Oh, here we go, okay. Trail is back on track. You know, we'll let some of that be a part of in character because it's more endearing, right? So.
The mind of a lemon wanders.
The mind of the lemon briefly derailed because something else caught his attention. Like maybe the how Theo's hair smells. So.
Wow.
So he re-rails, or whatever it's called. So. So I was thinking that we'd talk to her and talk to her about the gargoyles, because she obviously knows about them. And then by mentioning Timothy, and if the fact that she hasn't been told is true, which you have confirmed, then she may want to pay her respects, but in the way that little kids would want to, which means not going to a graveyard, because that's no fun, right? So, thinking maybe eventually going to get some flowers from the general store and then going back to the treehouse to leave them there, but that would also give us a chance to see if anything has changed. Two birds, one stone, right?
Yeah, well, I think heading back would be a good idea if we get a chance. I ran into Lauren at the library a little while ago when we were all on leave before, after the demon thing. Mm-hmm. And she mentioned she didn't know what had happened with Timothy. She asked me, but I told her that we hadn't found him. She said that she's asked her dad a couple times, but he gets upset when she does, so I don't know if she'll have kept asking him. And she said something about there being a secret part of the treehouse that was up above that only kids knew about.
Really?
And that she thought Timothy might have gone up there, but I don't know if maybe that's the part that Tomo climbed up to.
Oh, it might be.
Yeah.
Well,
so we could see if we head back if there's anything up above, or if that was just that little platform up there.
Yeah, we can go back. Well, provided that the treehouse appears the way it did to us before. Because that was the bigger version, wasn't it?
The one that we looked at, yeah, at first was the weird one. And then we went back in the daytime.
I'm thinking maybe during this we can kind of grill her on what else she may have keyed in on.
Mm-hmm. If she knows anything else that's been going on.
Yeah. So that's my thinking, and the first part of my plan was to go birdwatching. See if I can catch her.
Well, I would try the park.
Yeah.
I know. Yeah. The park, maybe the library. I don't know, maybe out near her house, if she's out in the front yard or something.
I was thinking more of the park.
It's a couple different places.
It's more of a public place, and we know that she likes to play there.
Yeah.
So, why don't we give that a whirl? And you're more than the invite is open if you would like to come along.
I mean, sure. I'll come with. I mean, it's probably better to have more people if we want to go look at the treehouse anyway.
Okay, so we could do this first part then, and then loop around and see if more people will come along.
Yeah.
Or something.
Oh, I was trying to remember the name of the other kid. It's Chris, because she mentioned that, oh, Chris hasn't come out to play in a long time and I'm bored.
It is Chris, because it's Wes's kid.
Yeah. Yeah, Lemons knows
which
this.
Lemons would know.
He's been...
Because he's been super
keeping tabs.
You can do a heart's job, Lemon!
Yeah! So, if Theo's agree to this, you can initiate part one.
Part one. Go.
Go catch the wild, Lorn.
You have the Cinnabon in tow.
Yay, Cinnabon in tow, and we have actual real food and not the fake awful stuff that Lemons was making.
And not a horrible sandwich. I hope you weren't planning to offer that to Lauren and just be like, look, I have food. Do you want some?
No, that was
and it like glops
me.
A horrible glob of like Cool Whip and shredded cheese out of like this soggy, moldy sandwich.
Oh my god. No, the only... was that in character?
No.
Okay. I was saying, because the only stuff that Lemons offers is stuff that Theo's cooked. He just takes it from the kitchen.
As long as you don't take it out of Nat's plate.
Well, that's for him. And for Nat, obviously, because the food war. So they're gonna go bird watching.
Ew.
Lorne's.
Okay, Dan. You might hear some blood burning in the background. Tori's doing some intense boss fights right now.
Okay.
It sounds intense.
It does sound intense.
You turn on your mic and it's just, whoa, whoa, da, da, da.
The choir is a...
Okay. You can do it, Tori. Yeah!
Yeah!
Can you still hear it? I turned my mic down.
No, it's fine.
Yeah,
it's
you're pretty good.
Fine. You're good.
Oh, goodbye, old hunter. Hey, congratulations, Tori. You did it.
No, she did it.
Now you can go be best friends with Jura.
Yay, she did it.
I want to watch that.
Oh. Do you need us to briefly pause while you watch her interact with Jorah?
Yes, please.
Okay.
I'm waiting so patiently to watch this.
We will
do pause it. Go on.
For this interaction.
Okay. I'm going to be on mute so you guys can just... Oh, you'll tell? Okay, we can do...
Okay.
We can go, and then as soon as she finds Jura, I'm out.
Okay.
You get an outie.
I'll come back.
Very important.
Okay. So they're going bird watching for Lorne's.
Yes.
At the park.
Okay. So you guys head out and go to the park. Roll a perception as you arrive at the park.
Boop, boop, boop.
And good job, all Blood. The eagles during these roll plays.
Yes.
Jesus.
Oh, well, at least you did.
Alright.
Little do I know, I actually find a bird that looks like the bird I had.
You're just chilling at the park. You know, doing your own parky park thing. Mm-hmm. And you just happen to look to your left and you see sitting in a tree. Wow, it looks a lot like Ms. Lime. How about that? Are those even indigenous to this area?
What?
There's a bird just sitting in the tree and it looks a lot like your bird. It's probably not, but it's just chilling.
He watches the Ms. Lime-like bird. He pulls up the really nerdy binoculars he brought for his... for the whole bird watching thing. It actually goes and looks at a bird.
You have gained +2 dice to be able to observe birds.
Observe bird.
So I roll my deces.
Yes.
Oh, -1 for half blindness.
No, I'm farsighted, thank you.
Did you find it already?
What?
This is the back entrance?
Oh, I think we're pausing.
Pausing.
Some very important video games.
Yes.
It's happening.
She's just talking to the monster lover. He's a little babe. From what I've seen.
Monster babe?
Yes, a monster babe.
Those are very important.
Yeah. Don't yawn, stop it. I was so tempted to have Lemons rest his head on either or his chin on either Theo's head or on his shoulder. So tempted.
Just do it. Give in, Lemons.
He didn't, because he's a good lemon, thank you. But he won't be able to resist in the future, I'm sure.
When he figures out what those feelings are.
I should just start, rolling just straight-up resolve.
Do it. Wits resolve, it's like when Theo has to roll to resist curiosity.
Because I think his feelings are starting to leaning towards that.
Oh.
Let me see.
Oh.
Checking the feels.
Gotta check the feelies.
Yeah, cause...
Sorry if I'm quiet. I'm currently rolling around on the ground to get my back un...
Oh no.
Untwinged.
Untwinged. Oh no. I feel you.
I was opening this morning and I was lifting a bag of espresso and I was like, oh!
Oh no. Don't get broke. We need you.
Stay alive. Keep your strong back.
Yeah. Henderson, lend me your strong back.
Lend me your strong.
Give me your strong.
Yeah, because Lemons is just like all crazy emotions for Theo right now.
Oh dear.
He's on the cares for about now. That's the most predominant color now.
He doesn't know what to do about it.
But he's also got the other one. The cares for immensely.
Oh.
He's got three little dots of that. Because it feels...
Super feelies.
Yeah. I don't know if he'd risk his life yet, though, or if he'd just, like, really lament not saving Theo if Theo was ever in trouble.
I love you, Theo, but that monster's kind of big. Bye.
Bye. <Pretty good. laughs>
If a mimic jumped on Theo's back, like a big mimic, like not, it looks not squishy like the mimics we... You know, some big shadowy monster jumped on Theo's back and was attacking him. Would Lemons run in to help?
Is anyone else around to help?
Everyone else is busy with their own monsters. Lemons has no monster engaged in him.
He might hesitate around. But he'd probably go in. Maybe I should alter one of those little baby dots.
Whoa. That escalated quickly, Lemons.
He doesn't understand.
But Theo, is it me? How can I care about something that isn't me?
Well, he just realized other people have emotions.
Yeah.
When he realized, holy shit, Henderson's angry.
Everyone in the room knew Henderson was angry. Henderson did not do a great job.
Well, it was a miracle that Lemons figured out.
Yeah, that was... Maybe that's the tipping point. That he realized that, oh man, other people are suffering, and oh gosh, the little Cinnabon is probably
like,
suffering
no.
most of all.
He's like, no, but I like this one.
And he's crying. And even though you get to hug him because he's crying, it's not nice.
It's like, no, stop crying. And also give me another reason to hug you.
Make it a good reason, like not a crying reason.
A pants off reason, maybe.
An adult reason.
We're horrible.
Well, it's what, the third month now?
Going on to it.
When everyone has been enduring constant, like, stresses.
Yeah.
Well, we just ended in October. And didn't everyone come in at the end of summer? So, like, the beginning of August? Oh, this is in the dock. I have the dock open. Yeah. I will look at the dock.
I thought it was, like, mid-September-ish when most of us showed up. But Theo was late. He showed up the last. So everyone... Everyone else showed up like a week before him.
First mission was on September 21st, so it's been like 8 months.
Well, it's like a month and a half.
Plus the tutorial.
A month and 9 days, or 10 days. Month and a third.
But life situations tend to alter perceptions.
Yeah.
Unless we're all very unrealistic. Highly... Yeah.
Is it unrealistic?
Jira is the best grandpa ever. Oh my god. I love him so much.
Are you happy?
Yes! Tari is running circles around him right now because they're friends. He is a nice grandpa.
You know, I'm gonna alter that little dot because I thought about it. Lemons would have helped Theo, but if he knows a thing's gonna kill him, like, he doesn't kill lemons.
You wouldn't risk it.
Not yet.
What's up?
We're debating Lemon's feelings. He's having a hard time.
I'm pleased with you, Tori.
He's not yet at the risk life to save stage of
he's really
of being
damn
friends.
Close, but he's not there yet. Because Inky posed the question, if Theo was getting attacked by a really big mimic and everyone else was preoccupied and Lemons wasn't, would Lemons go in there and save him? And I was like, yes, after hesitating for a round, but now I'm rethinking it. I'm like, eh.
If he thought he would die.
If he thought he would die, it's different
but
than
nope.
Taking damage.
Risk life, not 100% death.
Mm-hmm.
What percentage actual would friends. It have to be?
Did you just turn it off? Are you done with Bloodborne?
He would like to keep a large percentage of his life.
As would we all.
I mean, like, if it was a 30% chance of death, would he go? Like, a 1 in 3 chance. If it was a 1 in 10 chance of dying, would he go?
GG, Tori, GG.
We have to break down the lemon's emotions.
To get to the layers. We'll
yeah,
talk
no,
about this
well, you're getting really good at playing.
We got a role play to get back to, right?
Yeah.
Quietly deflects in a lemon-like manner.
Don't look at me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Distant lemony noises.
Yep.
Lemons, what are you up to? Shakes head.
Well,
we were making the comment that Lemons might have to start rolling resolve rolls. Like Theo has to do with curiosity.
Yep, only has to roll resolve against
against
being
feelings.
Yeah, being hands-on, so to speak, with Theo.
That is weird.
It's Lemons.
Lemons is weird.
Lemons is weird. You didn't notice?
Okay, so here's what I'm going to do to make it easier for me. Oh god, it's super grainy. Oh no, it's not! JK!
Should be a big picture.
No, don't worry about it. Because Brianna, good old Brianna, has a plan. We're gonna take your little player's thing and we're gonna move it. We're gonna move it far, far away. You're never gonna see this thing ever again. You know why? Because I'm using something new.
Oh.
Hey! Hey! And I will put your guys' tokens on so you can run around like little dips.
Boom.
Hey!
You might be temporary giants.
Okay.
Oh god.
Temporary giants.
Oh, I'm so.
Look at that tiny lemon.
Rawr!
Yay. Look, they're so little.
It's so tiny.
Aw, you can't zoom in any further. Why is that?
That is the most you can
picture was.
Okay.
Sorry, I couldn't make it any bigger. I mean, I could have, but it was already a really big picture.
I'll give you guys rights to your tokens.
Yay.
This way you can move around and I can track where you're going.
Yeah.
So... Lemons, save, and Theo.
I should have drawn some trees in the park. What kind of monster am I?
Busy one.
I suppose.
There you go. Run around, children.
Yeah.
Me.
Okay.
Not busy anymore, though.
So,
yeah. I'm free.
Where we left off,
slowly inching high lemons.
Where we left off, Lemons, you were staring intently at a bird.
Yes, I was staring very intently at a bird with binoculars. And mm-hmm. we were debating if my farsight was good enough and not have negatives with my broken glasses.
Your broken glasses probably only give you a negative one.
If I took them off to look at bird, would it be okay?
I'd say you'd be okay if you're farsighted.
Okay. I do.
You do.
I look at bird.
Wait, Bob, that's a copyright song. It's okay. I just turned it off in time. They'll never catch us.
How do you know when it's copyrighted?
Well, because I remember Theo's got copyrighted for it. His tutorial. I just want to play some. This one will work, I guess. I'm going to play this one.
You did the creepy glitch one.
Oh, it's not creepy.
Oh.
It's not creepy right now.
Oh. Oh. Get out of here. It's so creepy.
So, you zoom in on the bird. It's just chilling. Hi, bird. Hi, burb. Mm-hmm. Do you think you see a little nest nearby?
It's got a little burb family.
Still looks like Miss Slime.
It kind of does, yeah. I mean, you never really stared intently at Miss Slime. She was just kind of there.
Well, could I roll to see if I actually have zoned out on my bird before?
Sure.
I don't know what that roll would be.
You can roll a memory check or something.
Okay.
Memory roll for bird.
I'd give you -1 because you didn't even remember to grab your bird when leaving your house.
I actively decided not to. There's a difference. I said
he
so long, Miss
that bird.
So long, Miss Slime. Thanks for all the fish. Thanks for all the bird poops, I don't know.
Alright, go ahead if you would like to roll memory of your bird.
Okay.
Sweet fond memories of a bird.
Sweet fond memories.
Zoom, zoom, zoom.
As you contemplated eating it.
No, yeah, that's not your bird, it just looks like your bird.
I have 2 successes.
Yeah, it looks like a lime, but you don't think it's a lime.
Someone else's bird got free. It's not a kiwi, right? That's not a kiwi. Kiwi's dead. I hate kiwi.
That was ate by a cat.
Ghost kiwi whispers into your ear, why?
Why did you let me die?
Why?
Why did you light me on fire, Lemons? Stop wasting time!
Why? And you know, he's looking, staring intently at the bird, and then he, like, looks at Theo, and it's the binoculars just in his face. And he puts the binoculars down.
Theo sticks out his tongue at you, makes a dumb face with the very magnified binoculars.
Oh my god. Ugh, makes a fake ghastly noise. Have you seen her yet? Have you seen her yet?
Oh, Lauren? Theo was not paying attention! I didn't get any successes on notice.
You're just like, boy, this is a place.
Oh boy.
This is nice, it's fun to hang out in the park.
Kicks feeties.
Yep, kicks feet on the little blanket they're sitting on.
He goes back to using binoculars on other things he sees in the trees.
Okay.
Roll some more perceptions. Here. Eagle look around eyes. Too.
The car! Tell me what you get.
I got 5.
I got 2.
You see an eagle.
My eagle eyes see an eagle.
It's just chilling there, the proudest of all things, and you see it fly by and pick up the, the bird that you're just looking at, and just keep going.
Lemons makes a noise while he's watching it.
Oh no.
Hey Theo.
And the, It flies over you, so majestic, so free.
He just watches it.
Take away its dinner.
And he thinks, so long, Miss Possibly Lime.
So long, Space Cowboy.
Space Burb.
Theo, did you do another perception?
Yes, got a 2.
You're looking around, yeah, you're not seeing Lauren here.
I think we're out of luck. Could try the library.
Except that my eagle that just flew by may have just left a whole nest parentless. He's looking back at the nest with the binoculars.
Wait, what? Theo wasn't looking at the eagle. He did not see the bird.
He's like, oh, the eagle that just flew past snatched a bird, and there's a nest up there.
Oh no!
He just says all this offhandedly.
Why was it nesting in the fall?
I don't know.
This is a very confused bird.
We can go check it out. Since she's not here.
Well, I guess.
Or was which tree was it? Was it this tree or was it the one by the toads?
The one by the toads.
Trespassing. Not that it's really stopped them before, has it?
They used a similar excuse on the Elbricks. There was a bird.
There was a bird. And we're concerned. He's gonna use it as an excuse.
The eagle's bigger because it's closer to the screen.
Oh my gosh.
It's one of those golden eagles that, like, throws goats off of cliffs. Those things are huge.
Beautiful. It's just a beautiful bird. So majestic, much majesty.
Wow, so bird.
So bird.
And off it goes. So long, Space Cowboy.
Off into the sunset. How high up in the tree?
Probably above human height, so like 8 feet.
It's like a snail, but a bird.
I can climb up, right? Like it's not a hard thing to scooch up. I mean,
yeah, I would roll decent. Athletics.
Yeah,
you can add athletics. Strength to it if you'd like. Strength or dex, either yeah. or.
I can do that.
Okay, I can do that. That's 2.
Send Theo up.
Oh, okay. He can stand on his shoulders.
We're gonna make a tower.
Yeah.
What's the role for making a tower? Is it just Dex Athletics with an assist from Lemons?
Yeah. Lemons rolls first. Well, you need to roll the same thing. So if he's rolling a Dex Athletics... You have to roll Dex Athletics. Oh. If he's wrong, Strength Athletics, you have to roll Strength Athletics. It's gotta be the same roll.
Well, I'm not- I'm just standing still on the bottom, though.
Oh, you're just being a boost?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would give that a +1.
Okay.
What is your normal roll?
I have Dex 3, Athletics 2,
dang.
So 5.
Nimble,
so it'd be a 6.
Nimble little Cinnabon. Nimble bun.
So there you go.
Oh. Ooh. Nimble on.
Wow, get out of here, Inky.
Nimble on all over.
So you get up on his shoulder, it's a little shaky. You're just kind of standing there.
Really
you reach
shoulders.
And you grab the lowest branch and you just
little feet kicking in the air.
Yep. You're off you are off Lemons now and slowly ascending.
I made it.
Thumbs you make up. It to the first branch slightly winded, but there.
Obviously, Theo has to go climb more trees.
Well, he said it was only 8 feet up, so he should be able to see it.
Yeah, you're there. You see a nest.
Oh, does it have eggs or babies?
There are, in fact, eggs in this nest, yes.
Oh, no. he calls down, it was a mom.
Oh, no.
Roll of perception.
Both?
No, just you, Theo.
Oh. One success.
You're looking at these eggs, and you're like, eggs. And you look slightly to the right, and you're like, squirrel.
Is the squirrel going for him?
No, the squirrel's far away. The squirrel is actually not relevant at all.
He's just distracted.
Roll curiosity. Follow that squirrel.
Oh god, Theo falls out of a tree.
No. Lemons will try to catch you by just being underneath so you can just fall on him.
Blap. Yeah. This is some anime bullshit.
Going to save some bird eggs.
Well, I meant the falling out of a tree onto somebody.
That too.
But that hasn't happened yet. Don't get your hopes up, Lemon.
Can I do an animal ken to figure out why the butts there's bird eggs at this time of year?
Sure.
Okay. That's animal ken and intelligence or wits or blah, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Blah, one success. Which is pretty good.
And what did you roll for that? Intelligence, wits?
I rolled the animal ken and either intelligence or wits. They're both the same roll.
Okay, you could also roll academics.
I do not have that, so I'm not rolling it.
Okay. Because this is kind of a little misuse of animal ken. Mm.
I can roll academics.
This is definitely... more of a knowledge thing than I'm friends with animals.
If
thing.
You would like that, then I
yeah.
It.
Sorry. Oh dang. Okay, there you go. Well, if there's eggs this year, it's gotta belong to a bird that stays when it gets cold.
Mm. Okay.
Like an eagle. No, they're not eagle eggs. I can make God.
They're too small to be eagle eggs.
It's way too small to be eagle eggs.
Theo will call back down. What should we do about them?
Well, we could take them or leave them. He just looks up at Theo.
Shrugs. Lemons is just like, bird eggs. First a slug, and now a nest of birds. Jesus.
That's what I get for going with a diamond.
It's true.
What will you do with the egg?
You don't see a Lauren up in this tree, do you? Lemons looks higher.
Roll a perception, Theo. You get +1 for your vantage point.
Two successes.
Okay. You're looking around, and you're like, well, I'm in the vantage point. And just looking through a window, you just catch a glimpse through a window. Nope. And you're right next to the toad house, so... Oh. You see a little Lauren, looks like she's making a sandwich in the kitchen.
Everyone's making sandwiches.
Yeah, you wonder if her sandwich is as terrible as Lemon's.
I hope not. I hope it isn't a horror sandwich. It was just like, oh, she's home.
That's good, I guess. Well, we can't really... Seem kind of weird if we tried to talk to her.
Just go knock.
Right. Yeah.
Ho ho ho, it's Santa.
Ho ho Hello. Ho, it's your local not police.
Yep.
Don't scream.
Oh god.
Can they tell if a parent is home? Like, is there a car in the driveway or anything?
There is not a car in the driveway.
Is the garage open? Is there a garage?
I don't know. You want to roll a perception?
Sure.
I'll just give this stuff to you.
And I still have binoculars, so I'm going to use them.
Okay. Even though you're standing right in their yard.
We can zoom in on the window.
What do my binocle eyes see?
You see a gravel path leading up to a little box house. And there doesn't seem to be a garage. Or maybe you're just too zoomed in to the side of the house. You're not sure.
Takes the binoculars, puts them down.
puts the glasses back on.
Well, I guess we could go knock. Question mark. There's a very audible question mark.
What would we say?
I don't know. We just come back later. And go bird watching tomorrow. Speaking of birds, what are we gonna do about those eggs?
Cheese.
Cheese?
No, I said geez. Lemons is like eggs with cheese.
Yeah. Omelets, that sounds great.
What a great idea.
Oh gosh.
Yes, he said.
Eggs with cheese. It's terrible. Can I roll a perception to see if there's any evidence of there being two birds in this nest? Like different colored feathers or something?
Sure.
Bet. One success.
I'm sorry, I blanked. What? What were you looking for again?
To see if there are two birds in this nest, like if it was both parents' birds were taking care of the eggs, if there were like different colored feathers or whatever.
What'd you get?
A one success.
I'd say you make it. You look at, and yeah, there's different color feathers here.
Because it seems like another parent bird will be back, then he might leave them, but if it doesn't, then he might take the freaking bird nest. Because it's Theo.
It seems like there might be someone.
Another bird. Okay.
Might be another bird in the picture.
That's okay, good. So... Alright. So he will come down from the tree, okay. But he will check before they leave if another bird is there.
You're just gonna roll a perception, or?
Do you take the binoculars from me?
Check the binoculars. Well, are we going to knock, or are we heading out?
We'll just try again later. This isn't urgent.
Try again later?
Yeah.
Before you do anything, though, you need to roll to look for that other bird. silly child.
Does Lemons hand the binoculars up?
Does Theo make it clear he wants them?
God, Theo.
You gotta voice your needs. Yeah, he'll ask to borrow them.
Yeah, he holds them up.
Can I grab those quick for a sec?
Yeah, here you go.
Bloop. Binoculars plus get.
Plus get.
Yes. Three successes.
Ayo. You're looking and you zoom in because this is important.
It is.
I feel like this may
the lives be the of most, three birds or
this
whatever.
Is the lives of eggs.
How many are in the nest?
What kind of person would you be if you couldn't protect these eggs? These eggs, these like, what, three eggs at most? I made a token, look.
Oh god, it's so huge.
Hello, friend. I'll make your even smaller since it's a chat. Boop. Okay. Alright, so, how much did you get? Let me look here. Three. You see a bird flying in. It just sits down next to the nest.
Is it going for it?
It's just chilling there.
Just chilling.
You do not.
You're waiting for it to hop in the nest.
You know,
he has to make sure it's the right bird and not like another bird coming in.
It turns out to be a blue jay and it just flies off with an egg.
Fucking assholes. Blue jays are giant jerks.
They are the worst.
You stare intently. Zoom in.
Zoom in on bird.
Zoom in on bird.
Very
and
important.
You fail to notice the child comes out of their house.
Do I see the child?
Roll lemons to see the child.
This is my singular minus, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you've got your glasses.
Yeah, you see Lauren walk out her back door with a sandwich in hand. To you guys standing in her yard. It was Theo staring up at a tree with binoculars.
Lemon smiles at her. Hey.
Hi.
I found a bird.
Spins around. Binoculars still on his face. Zooms out. Drops the binoculars. Hey.
Hi. What are you doing?
Oh, there's a bird nest up there. And he'll point it out.
Oh, yeah.
It has one less parent bird because an eagle took it. he just smiles at her. This is totally normal, okay?
My music changes are flawless.
Eagle to... Okay. Cool.
Well, we were in the park and we saw an eagle fly off with something and Lemon spotted the nest that it took it from. So
didn't know
we just wanted to see if there were any eggs up there. If we needed to move them or something.
You can just leave them. You're not supposed to touch baby birds, you know?
Does Lemons know that's a wives' tale?
I don't know, do they?
I don't know. He was never told by his mom.
She didn't have time to educate him about the birds and the bees.
He ate the baby birds he found, so...
Oh my god.
That's why the mother never took them back.
Sounds there weren't any babies.
Oh gosh, out of character, thinking about how he's gonna breach the subject of gargoyle. He kind of sits there and thinks for a second.
Yeah. Well, Theo will talk with Small. Well, it seems like it might be all right anyway. Another bird showed up, so if it's the other parent, then maybe they'll be okay.
She starts scrambling up a tree. Not that tree, but a different one.
I'm listening.
I'm listening.
She's trying to see the birds from the other tree.
Yes.
Do you want the binoculars?
Yes.
Theo will hand them up.
Your tiny baby arm comes down and grabs the binocular. And she looks and she's just like,
So, speaking of things you've seen...
Nice segue.
He's boss at this, right?
So good job, Lemon.
So boss, he learns from the best, aka Gloria. Who probably doesn't have any segues and just jumps from subject to subject.
So I heard you were talking to someone the other day. We were just talking
Tell
about
me all
cakes,
about
Gloria.
It.
Jesus Christ, Gloria.
Gloria, Mick, I have no chill.
So I've heard about these things that can be on rooftops.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I've seen one of these things.
What, birds?
No. It's kind of like just like that slap of the hand. No, you know, something bigger. More spooky.
Curses.
you know, like the kind of things that are over by Catherine's place.
Who?
Cece. Couple houses down from Timothy's place.
Oh, the witch?
The witch.
Oh, no.
Yeah. She's an evil witch. That's why everyone's scared to go there.
Why do you call her a witch?
Why? Because she is. Because she hangs upside down from the tree with the binoculars hanging from her wrists.
Tell me more.
Well, there's a scary witch who lives down on, This is the story. There's a scary witch that lives at the end of Ash Lane. And she never leaves her house because she's too busy making spells in her cauldron. And when she does, you better be away because she'll gobble you right up. And only a few people can go see her because they bring offerings.
You mean like Abe from the grocery store?
Mm-hmm.
Bringing her groceries up.
Bringing her offerings, yeah.
Uh-huh. Pulling my leg, aren't you?
Smiles. Yeah, the kids believe it.
Yeah, well. You're not like other kids, right?
I make the stories. I don't believe them.
So what about the stories of the big stone things that like to walk around on rooftops?
The night crawlers.
Is that what you call them?
Yeah. And they're not made of stone.
They look like they do.
Mm-mm. No.
No.
What are they made of?
They're not stone.
Just not stone.
Ask Kenderson, he looked at one.
Yeah, he did have a nice close look at its foot.
Just swinging.
Before he noped.
Swinging your hair, just kind of like, woo, woo.
How many nightcrawlers are in town, do you know?
Everyone has a nightcrawler. They live in your shadow, so you can't look back at them. And they like to sit on the roof. And they watch you wherever you go, every time you leave outside at night.
We don't have any night crawlers by us.
Well, yeah, you do. You just don't see them.
Out of character, we don't go out at night.
What about mirrors? What do you know about mirrors and night crawlers?
You're not supposed to look at them no matter what. Because they're watching you, but you're not supposed to watch them.
But you still play peekaboo with them. So you can.
When you look at them, the only time you can see a nightcrawler is if it's up on the roof. Other times you won't be able to see it, because it's right behind you. But they like to sit on the roofs, and so you can look at them then, because they won't get mad.
So only if they're close, they get mad.
You're not supposed to see them. It's like a game of hide and seek. And your friends usually can't see them either. Because they're just perfectly in your shadow. They're night crawlers. And she smiles.
Clemens is thinking. Kind of like does that, like, drumming his fingers on a tree while he's thinking.
And that's not the only thing either.
No?
There's a bunch of other things too.
Oh. Tell me more.
Okay.
She's like, okay.
She's really excited.
I found the child Gloria.
And she gets down from her tree and...
To the park.
Yes.
I need my thinking swing.
So she goes and she sits on the swing.
He goes, she's like, or Lemons recollects.
Is she related to Chaney? This is a small town.
Maybe.
Here's the thing. There's the night crawlers, but there's also the corn monsters.
They're the ones that make it look like there's wind, but there isn't.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Kind of like night crawlers. They don't like being seen. And so, one time, I went with a group of friends, and we split off in between the boys and the girls, and we all had whistles. And we went, and it was just a game, because we like to play in the corn. And so, we went into the corn, and while we were traveling, we heard the loud whistle from the boys' team. And we were like, huh, what's that? You know, so we tried going through that. And then suddenly something speeds past us and moves the corn. And it's at night, by the way. And
his eyebrows kind of shoot up.
And something speeds past in the corn, and we're like, well, what's that? And everyone splits off and trying to find the exit to the corn, because we go really, really far in and following those aisle things, but they're not really evenly planted, so it's hard to get through. And I'm running. And I turn. And there's this thing. And I hear like this ruffle, and I'm like, no. And so I turn and run out of the cornfield. And just as I get out and fall backward, there's this thing. And it comes diving out of the cornfield. And it's like a velociraptor with big talon things and short arms and sharp teeth. And as soon as it gets out from the corn, it turns to dust.
Oh.
And then it floats into the wind.
Have you guys ever had any mishaps?
Huh?
Anyone get hurt?
No. When you were out in the corn?
No.
You were all okay?
Yeah. We play corn wars.
It's where corn wars. In the middle of the night.
It's where you take the corn out of the corn stalks, and you find someone, and you chuck the corn at them. But you gotta be careful. You can't play with... We like to make our own paths sometimes, so we'll break down the corn. But you gotta wear shoes, because corn can get really sharp and cut your feet.
Mm. Good to know.
Now, we like to change up. There's a bunch of areas where you can play corn wars.
There's lots of corn.
Yeah, there is a lot of corn. But the farmer sometimes gets mad at us, so we had to move our corn wars.
What'd the farmer look like?
He was tall and drove a tractor.
He kind of smiles.
Who covers his face a little.
Did he ever yell at you guys?
Mm-hmm. He was really mad and scary.
He actually yelled.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa. Scariest thing I've heard yet from this girl.
If it was him.
Well, was he wearing a big hat?
No.
Well, different farmer. How often...
Confirm with hat.
Yeah. How often do you guys play outside at night? Mm. You know about the curfew, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Curfews are there for reasons. But I won't tell.
Good.
Theo holds up his hand. Pinky promise.
Pinky promise.
Cross it's my okay. Heart, hope to die, stick a needle in my eye.
It's okay, because there's times where you can go out and it's okay, because they won't know it was curfew.
They won't? The things, or your parents?
The parents. Wow. It's okay, so long. Usually we just stick around my house and it's okay.
Stay close to home.
Not their home. My home. My home's cool. Mm-hmm. In the park.
Oh.
So stuff doesn't usually come out near the park?
We play Ghost in the Graveyard. Have you ever played that? It's fun. But you can only play it during summer nights. Though it is the best during winter nights.
Why only during summer? Just because it's warmer?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Though, during winter nights, it's fun too, but there's not as much stuff to hide behind. Oh. And you can't play Corn Wars either.
Right.
No, you don't have the corn.
No. It's no fun.
So, since you've been playing this stuff for a while, you haven't had any issues of forgetting what time it is, have you?
I don't have a watch.
It doesn't feel like things just go too fast.
Well, when it's school time, it does. It goes too slow.
Yeah, Lemons doesn't think he's going to get a straight answer for this one. He wants to mention the other stuff too, but, you know, kids. He doesn't want to prompt her into looking for something.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Last time... last time we made a fort.
Yep.
I said I was going to go check out Timothy's, his house, and I did.
Oh, you went down? Did your dad go with you?
No.
You went all by yourself?
Uh-huh. It's just the woods. I'm not scared of the woods.
Famous last words.
And I checked out the secret spot. Because it's really fun, you know, and you had all the drawings and stuff.
Yeah.
And it was the secret spot. No one can find the secret spot, not even the Nightcrawlers.
No.
Any luck?
No shadows can get up there?
Mm-mm. It's the secret spot.
Oh.
That's where Timothy liked to spend the night. He had set up a swing there so he could watch.
Yeah. So you went over there.
Mm-hmm.
And?
The swing's broken.
And there was nothing in the secret spot?
It was the same old secret spot. It's no fun when no one else is around.
Glance at Lemons.
Lemons is, he's thinking. Out of character, it was broken, or we found it broken because that's what happened, right?
Yeah, we found the swing broken because he presumably fell from it.
Okay. He's just kind of, looking at her. How long ago did you go out there?
Well... Are you gonna tell my dad?
No.
Pinky promise, right?
Pinky promise. I'm shoulder pinky.
Another pinky promise.
Now you're double pinky promise. If you break it, the Nightcrawlers are gonna get you.
Oh, I super won't break it then.
Okay. Out of character. What was the question again? Sorry.
How recent was she out there?
I went out there probably 3 days ago.
Was it a big treehouse or a little treehouse?
It's always been a little treehouse. Mm-hmm. Well, it's super big, but I wish it was bigger. It's better than my treehouse.
You have a treehouse.
Laura, yeah, I'll show you.
Oh. Running back
completely,
and forth.
Completely trespasses on someone else's property. And she points up in a tree, and you see a single board nailed to a decently thick trunk horizontally. That's my treehouse.
It's a good attempt.
Oh, so you're just getting started.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what we'll call it.
It's sort of like a bunch of nails haphazardly sticking up in places where there might have used to been boards.
Oh, no.
I made it myself.
So, I'm thinking about how Lemon's gonna break it to her, because she should know. Lauren, about his secret place. Maybe it was secret, but maybe it wasn't exactly the safest place.
No. No, it's okay.
Why is it okay? What would make it okay?
Because it's a secret safe place.
Oh, no. But it broke.
Well, yeah, stuff breaks.
And it wasn't very safe. You're just kind of looking at her, seeing if she can kind of piece together.
She looks confused.
He's gonna kneel more to her level. How old is she again?
She's about 10.
Okay, so kneeling would be about her level, right?
Yeah.
Lauren, so we know that Timothy was your friend, a really good friend too. And I don't know why anyone hasn't told you. But and
guilty shuffling in the background.
And I think as his friend you should know, and it would be mean for no one to tell you. But his secret secret swing, maybe it was safe. Maybe it was very safe from everything that was out there. But it wasn't very safe when he was on it and it broke.
Huh?
Oh no, music.
You remember when we came by and to help find him because he was missing, right?
Yeah.
And we found him. And he wasn't around anymore.
He was leaving?
In a very strange sense, he's passed on.
From Kylesville. Which makes sense, because he was always telling us about how he's going to go on this grand adventure around the world.
He just kind of gnaws on his lip.
So he finally what?
He fell, Lauren, and he didn't get back up.
From where?
You understand? The swing broke and he fell from that height.
Theo will kind of get down, sit down on the ground. He fell and he got really hurt, and there was no one around to help.
Why?
He was out there alone, and it sounded, well, you said like it was late at night when he went out, so...
But that was the safe spot.
And it was safe. It was safe from everything else that was out here. But safe things, sometimes they can break too.
No.
She says no.
No.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Oh, she stretched.
No. Uh-oh. We should probably go get her.
Probably.
Oh, one second. Let me grab my book.
Lauren, wait.
Lauren.
Zoom. Roll a stamina athletics to keep up with the running child.
Lovely.
Yeah, for extended running.
Wee. Hey, success.
Yay, you did it too!
Good job, Lemons.
He's got the stamina, he don't have the athletics.
You guys are running, and while you're keeping up, she's definitely gaining. A lot.
Lauren?
She's weaving through the trees like an expert.
He's fine, I'm gonna go check!
Lauren?
Well, let us come with you. Oh no.
Where's she going?
I think she's going back to treehouse. Wait, where
tree house is
she? Oh, is she going to the cornfields?
Roll a perception as she gains, you know, goes more into the foliage. It's hard to keep track of where she is.
Ooh. Bam, 4.
Nice.
You see her, Theo.
You zoom in.
Zoom.
Zoom in with your eyes.
Where is she going?
Lauren, where are you going? The treehouse isn't over there.
You had a special place.
Oh.
Somewhere else.
And I have to go to the bathroom. Burb.
Body.
He's probably hiding there.
Well, why don't we all go check together?
No, it's our special place. You're not allowed.
Oh, no.
You have to make sure you'll be okay.
I'll be fine. Leave me alone.
Maybe she's trying to get us lost in the woods.
Perception and stamina checks.
Oh, boy.
Yes, perception. No stamina.
That was with athletics?
Yeah.
1 perception, 2 for stamina.
You are gaining on Lemons, Theo. Lemons is losing breath.
No, yeah, you're going past me and go on, I got my phone.
Okay, I've got mine too. We really should have brought the walkie-talkies.
I think Lemons still has his on him, but it doesn't go that far.
Yeah.
He could always call the house, but he's not. I mean, yeah. They went out in, you know, before noon.
So yeah, we should have.
Should be fine.
Time.
I mean, famous last words, but still.
So, Lemons, you stay behind.
Well, he's now doing like that fast walk.
Nonetheless, they're running. Himself. You are fast walking,
right?
So,
let's follow the.
He's following the broken trail that's being left by Theo.
You're not allowed to come with! Go away!
I don't know what to say to that.
See, you just keep following.
Yeah.
As you're following, she scrambles up a tree.
Oh, as long as she's staying in one spot.
Roll of perception.
Bloop. 3.
You see she is crossing tree to tree now.
Oh no. God. Arin, wait. Oh my gosh.
And she's climbing. So some of these are really sketchy trees she's climbing.
Oh no. Lauren, you're gonna get hurt. Wait.
Go away!
She warped again.
I'm trying. It's hard to hold a tiny token.
It's true. They're so small.
Like, you don't have to worry about warping yours.
Nope.
All you can do is move it.
And spin in a circle. Woo!
But I can't do that. I don't have that kind of power. And roll stamina.
Do success.
You keep up. And I need to roll here. And she's definitely slowing down, so the closer you get, the higher she's climbing. stay away.
No.
If you don't want me to come up, it's fine. I'll wait outside, but... And
we
you can
are
go
outside!
Check.
Go inside!
There's no inside nearby!
I don't want you nearby!
Look, I'll wait while you go check, okay? But I don't want to leave.
No, because then you'll just follow me.
I pinky promised, remember?
I don't trust you.
Can I ask her what would make her trust you?
Well, why not? What can I do?
Leave!
That was the way. I knew it.
Other than that...
What else?
Could tell her
nothing.
Could tell her that, you know, you just don't want her to fall out of the tree.
She scampers higher up the tree.
Oh, God.
And as she does, a stick breaks.
Oh no.
A lower feet. And well, gravity's a thing that happens when someone falls out of a tree.
Can I dive catch this child?
You can try to dive catch the child. She was ahead of you, however.
Oh, no. Oh God. What
Don't
am I
forget
rolling?
You can willpower.
I can willpower. What am I rolling for dive catching this child?
Catching objects is dex athletics.
Yeah.
But if this is like a sprint and lunge and catch, that could also be strength. Because just can you get there fast enough?
Yeah. Roll.
Strength
roll.
Or dex?
Athletics. Dex.
Okay. And I'm going to put a willpower in.
Oh no.
I will mark that off.
pray to the eagle.
Oh, well... At some point, we will probably recover willpower, but... Whap. There's one.
Yeah, I was gonna say, because we got the whole week.
I'll just make a note that I spent it during the week. So when we start next mission, I'll be down one. Alright. Dex Athletics plus willpower. Which is pretty good.
Oh!
You can baby success!
Give me a moment. So you run into a catcher before she hits the ground, and so that no serious damage will be done, I'm gonna try and find a new song here or something. What's annoying
I
about
can look up falling rules if you want. Or have it open.
And you're getting there. And problem is, she's really, really high up.
Oh, jeez.
And so it's going to take a while before she comes to you first.
Maybe she can grab a branch on her way down. Fingers crossed.
And she hits a few branches. And by a few, I mean quite a bit on her way down. And you do catch her. But... It's only after, you know...
You smacked into a bunch of stuff.
The yelling stopped.
Oh no.
Falling damage is bashing unless your character lands on a spike. A person suffers one bashing wound for every 3 yards fallen.
Oh jeez.
Terminal velocity is achieved in a fall of 30 yards or more. Damage is lethal at that point. So if your character falls 30 yards, he loses 10 health points to lethal damage.
But she's been hitting stuff on the way down.
Right.
Yeah. Well, 30 yards is also a lot higher than probably what she was climbing.
She was probably like 10 yards up.
And so, you catch her. She's got twigs in her hair and her arms bent a little funky.
Oh no.
she's just kind of wincing with tears falling down her face. You don't know if that's from falling or before that. And she's just like...
Oh no.
Back to the hospital at Sturgeon's Bay.
Yep. Okay. Jeez.
Jeez. Slowly making my way over there. Yeah.
Lemons is slowly coming over, Theo, carefully.
Roll a perception, Theo.
Oh no. Bloop. Two.
Two?
Yes.
You look around. And you see through the trees there seems to be something.
Huh?
You can't tell, but it definitely looks like something.
Further ahead, there's a thing. Hmm?
Hmm? Are you talking to me, or...?
There was a ping.
That was me trying to move
I think it was
token.
Just a lemon.
Any purple is me, don't worry.
So there's something further ahead, I asked.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I guess there's actually a thing out here. But he will carefully, just make sure that she's okay.
She does not seem okay right now.
And I'm sure, small child, but other than the arm, is she okay?
She seems a little bashed up, maybe has a concussion.
Oh no.
And emotionally not happy at all.
Yep.
Just kind of curled up into a ball at this point and pretended you stopped existing.
Oh no.
Does Lemons finally catch up?
Lemons, she's... I'm here. I'm Lemon.
Whew, should I roll to figure out what just happened, like, from just looking at it?
Yes.
Perception?
Sure.
With my minus one.
I think if anything, it'd be an intelligence check, but you know what, whatever.
Whatever, I made it.
Yeah. So, yeah, you figure based on the twigs and everything, fell out of the tree.
Oh my god. Let me take a look at that.
Yeah, we should get back.
Yeah, we don't have any supplies here. Like, I'll just look and not touch anything, because it's bad. Is that intelligence medicine?
Yes.
Okay.
Or I'd say wits medicine, since you're looking.
Okay, wits medicine, emergency care, or should
yes.
I just not? Okay. 5+, okay. 2 success.
Looks like definitely going to be a lot of bruises. Luckily, nothing super terrible anywhere else except her arm. Arm's definitely not terribly broken, but you're thinking definitely fractured and dislocated at the shoulder.
Dislocation? That can be dealt with immediately, I believe.
Yeah, you can pop it back in, but it'll hurt.
It'll hurt, but that'll be one less medical bill.
Yeah.
And she won't be in pain after it's popped back in.
Well, I don't know if you want to be tugging on an arm that's also fractured.
True. Can't tell where...
But that's a medical roll to find out.
Well, yeah, you rolled a 2, so...
That one would be intelligence if you want to figure out how to fix that.
I will figure out how to fix that. 1.
Yeah. You figure your fracture's probably around elbow area if you try and tug it above that. It'd be kind of risky, though.
It would be risky. I mean, we're still running her back, though. Which is still jostling a dislocated arm. She seemed to be really in pain.
She doesn't seem at all happy right now.
She's crying and curled up into a ball and not saying anything. She's
Is there a roll to figure out if this is a good idea?
Common sense.
I don't have common sense.
You may roll.
Roll what?
Oh geez, common sense? You don't have it.
I know, that's what I said. I don't have common sense.
One second, I found a child crying sound effect.
No. Oh no.
For you.
No.
No.
That's baby. That's really young, though.
It's all I can get. I work with what I can get.
Better without it.
we'll accept that the crying is happening.
Yes, we'll pretend it's happening.
I cannot cry for you right now, I'm sorry.
It's okay, you don't have to.
Save your tears.
You can just say that is crying and we will accept it as crying.
Okay.
Like when we say Sara is crying, my bird, you don't have to always pretend that the bird is crying.
Do the burp sound.
Well, we can try to move her, and if it really starts to bother her, then we can try to pop it in place.
I think Lemons would probably know this, but the longer you wait, it kind of gets harder because it swells up.
Well, time to pop it right now, then. I'm really sorry. This will probably hurt a little bit, but I need to... It's dislocated to pop it back into place. He just kind of mutters an apology as he... Well, he does it.
Do it.
Do it.
Just without warning. Three, two, go!
Medicine and... What? Strength?
Emergency care?
It would just be a normal medicine roll, so I'd say dex. Dex meds.
Okay.
Emergency
care?
Yeah.
Dos.
I did it. Pop. You do it. It's like when you have those little something stuck and you gotta pull it out, only it's reverse where you're trying to shove it back in.
No.
But it goes in, and she definitely makes unhappy sounds of protest, of pain, as you put this bone back in the socket.
Yeah, it'll feel better, I promised. And he kind of, shoulders in to pick her up because he's got more strength than Theo does, I think.
Theo got two.
Oh, he's got three, so I guess whoever wants to carry her.
Plus one crying child.
Oh no. Lemnitz is taller.
Yeah. So he has taken on the child. The shield. Well, can we figure out where the hell we are?
Do either of you have...
I do not have direction sense.
Direction sense or tracking of any sort?
I have survival.
You can try and use survival.
With survival?
Yep. Yeah. Nope. You have no idea.
Lauren, what way's the... I know it hurts. What way is the closest to the nearest road?
No, Lauren just kind of buries her face in your coat and does not respond.
Can we see the trail that we made on our way in?
Perception.
Oh god. Nope. Hey,
Theo. You see an eagle sitting on it. You didn't even get a crit success, but there he is, sitting on your path.
There's that damn eagle.
That eagle that ate that bird that started to fall.
You feel like you see the bird's feathers hanging from the eagle's face.
Oh, God.
Just looks at you and flies away.
Out this way. Come on.
Okay. I'm gonna start walking back.
Should I do some extended rolls to... Honest, the way back out.
I can say you guys find your way back via eagle.
Yay! What a nice eagle.
Oh. Eagle's here to help you out. He'll eat your friends and then leave.
Thanks, eagle.
And you guys make it back to town.
Okay.
Burp, burp, burp.
Should we just move our coin where?
Yeah, just here. I got you.
I've removed.
We got you.
God, well, it's so hard to pick this one up.
Too tiny.
There we go.
Where are we taking her back to?
Well, I don't know where you guys are going, but there you go.
Well, we left from, you know, her house.
We don't know
where. So they could go to her parents and say she fell out of a tree in the park.
True.
You did promise you weren't gonna say she was in the woods or whatever.
Yeah.
So what do?
Well, we're gonna try the house.
Okay. By the time you get back, you do notice there is a car in the driveway. Knocky knocky on the door, and the plump woman with her hair up in a bun opens the door. She's like, hello?
So, out of character, since, I mean, would the woods work? I mean, because the parks, or would the park work? Because it's right there.
Hmm. Well, there's also trees in the backyard.
True.
Oh, they would have drove by the park, though, and saw that nobody was out there.
We could have said that she had wandered by our place. It's not technically woods down there, it's just thicker trees.
Oh, by the base? Yeah.
Okay, either way, he's carrying her.
Okay.
And
immediately, as soon as the mother sees, you know, face changes completely.
She was playing in the trees by our place, and she fell out.
Oh my goodness.
She had a dislocated shoulder, and I was able to pop it back into place, but I think her arm's fractured.
She doesn't even wait for you to finish talking. She goes straight to the phone and calls an ambulance.
Comes in.
They're on their way. Wow. We have a first aid kit. Is there anything? Make a sling, maybe?
I'll clean up some of the cuts while we wait.
Yeah. I can make that roll for her, right? With the first aid?
Yeah. Plus two for first aid kit.
Hey, yo. What's the medicine?
Yep.
Emergency care.
She kind of wipes her face worriedly. It isn't the first time.
Oh, no.
She really likes her trees, huh?
Oh, yeah. Is that... Wow, that's a lot of heals.
Yep, 4 heals. If
you don't just slap a bandage on her face.
I probably... Would that encompass the splint then, too?
Yes, you put a splint in everything. Eventually the ambulance does come, and they take her, and Mother goes with it, and she thanks you guys for helping out.
Okay.
I didn't get your names.
Oh, I'm Guy.
Theo.
Hello, Guy. Hello, Theo. thank you for the child. I'll properly thank you when I get back. Bye.
Yep, and they just whisk off. Well, that was a thing.
Oh, jeez. That didn't go well.
It didn't. Oh, he didn't see, or Lemons never saw the thing in the forest, so he can't even comment on that.
There was something back there, though.
Was there?
Couldn't really make it out, but she was definitely heading towards something.
We should go there sometime. Not now, obviously.
Well, yeah.
But I think
you think we'll be able to find our way back?
We know the area. I mean, we can keep sweeping it till we find it. I don't know.
Sometime early in the day, then?
Yeah. In case Omega shows up or something. Well, that was a thing. Hopefully, she should heal up real fast. They don't know she was in the woods, so we're good there. She shouldn't get in trouble other than for falling out of a tree. and as rough a delivery as it was, now she knows.
I don't know if she believes us.
No. She hasn't seen him, so...
Hmm.
I don't know, we'll see.
Yeah, she's pulling a Henderson.
Yeah, that's why she was crying so hard and in denial so hard.
Yeah.
Probably. Is that what Henderson's gonna do? Running off into the woods.
Oh no.
Climbs a tree and falls and breaks his arm.
He'd be running off into the caves.
Oh no.
Climbs a cave wall, falls, breaks his arm.
Boo-hoo, boo-hoo, boo, my baby, my shun.
Little double tears.
My child ain't dead, he's on a grand adventure.
Oh no. With my wife.
No.
The great adventure of the digestive system.
Oh my gosh.
Well,
you are consistently the worst.
We'll end with this cute picture.
Sad RP ends with cat trim.